Yeah, Mukta from Maitri, and Maitri also has been a big player. They always cross 100. I hope this year they cross 200 registrations.
We're trying.
Can you talk about Maitri and okay?
Yeah, thank you so much for having us here.
Sure.
Maitri is based in San Jose, and it serves South Asian families who experience domestic violence, cultural displacement, and all other kinds of unresolved conflict. By South Asian, I refer to the Desi subcontinent, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Burma, Bhutan, Fiji Islands, and other ethnic and geographic populations that share cultural similarities and patterns in familial conflict and familial life. You can reach us at 1-888-8-MAITRI or check our website at www.maitri.org. Or write to us at maitri@maitri.org to find out how you can call for help or offer your help. Our staff and volunteers speak close to 18 different languages, among Hindi, Urdu, Bengali, Marathi, Gujarati, Punjabi, Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, and others. Maitri's philosophy is educating, enabling, and empowering victims of domestic violence to move towards a life of safety and dignity as survivors. We provide a bridge that connects those in need with existing services and create new services when the ones that we need aren't in operation. We get calls from the Bay Area, from out of state and out of country sometimes, but primarily our work is here in our own backyards in the Bay Area among our local immigrant communities. We have a toll-free helpline that you can call to seek assistance for yourself or your loved one. We have life skills grants that help you stand on your own feet. So, for example, emergency grants if you've been evicted forcibly from your own family homes, if you want to learn to drive, speak English, gain career skills, or enhance your educational qualifications. We offer bus passes, legal service support, court accompaniments, and counseling for both adult and child victims of domestic violence. We have a transition home for extended stay, so you don't have to worry about a roof over your head or your children's safety, but you can focus during this safe time on making transitions and achieving goals that help you become productive and vibrant members of society. Since we began 25 years ago, we have received 38,400 inquiries and over 4,500 serious cases in deep crisis. We have empowered over 3,300 plus survivors, helped with over 1,400 legal cases, given close to $800,000 in legal, living, educational, medical, and emergency grants, and guided 202 women and children transition from transition housing into safe homes. We have now reached a point where the people that we have served have come back to serve other people in need. So it's a full circle. Because abuse thrives on isolation, alienation, and either a lack of or misguided information, our primary goal is to provide knowledge and resources by which you can make informed decisions about your lives. We do not advise or counsel, but we support and hold your hand through what can be your darkest hour. When even your own family might shun you, we give voice to the silence that surrounds your pain and confusion. Because domestic violence in our culture often shames and blames the victim and provides little or no recourse, we offer the rarest and the most dire resource, which is hope. We're delighted to be present at the Save-A-Thon with all these other really amazing agencies and show solidarity to the community and service in partnership.
Excellent, excellent. And how are you benefiting from Save-A-Thon?
Well, like you said, we've been a really strong partner in Save-A-Thon. The last 4 years, we have received the Spirit Award, which is awarded for recruiting a large number of recruiters to run for this. Domestic violence is a really taboo subject. Mm. It's a dark subject. It happens within the confines of the four walls. And there's a lot of sort of misunderstanding around the subject, as well as misgivings about whether you should help somebody who you think is in quote unquote a private problem. Is it your problem to intervene? What platforms like the Save-A-Thon do is it pulls this out of secrecy and puts it out there in the open. It tells the community that it is equally their responsibility to support victims and make them survivors, so that we're not just making sure people live and get through their experiences, but that they thrive. And in this, in shattering the silence, I think is the biggest benefit of agencies and support services like the Sevathon. I also think that all of us in nonprofits are constantly doing really, really hard work with small communities of people. And this is a great way in which you can make the connections and join the dots, so to speak, among what's happening in the home countries with Isha, for example, and what happens in the host countries. And since most of the migrant population has a foot in each of these places, it's really amazing that this platform provides a bridge that connects everyone together.
Excellent.